Turn the ignition on. Fuel gauge doesn't move. And there's plenty of gas. And the fuel gauge is good. That means the sender is bad. Let's tackle that. Hey guys, welcome back to another fix-it. The fuel tank sending unit is bad on this bus. So what we're gonna do is cut a hole, an access panel, and yank that sucker out and take a look. Right behind the rear bench seat and near the engine access on a later bay, I've marked the spot where I'm pretty sure the sending level or sending unit is. Found that this is about an inch and a half to the right, just due to some Samba research. And what we can do is base that off of the center line here. So we're about an inch and a half to the right. And what I'm going to do is basically cut an access hole right here to make sure I have plenty of room to pull it out. And then we'll look at patching that back up. We're pretty close. If I hold it directly over the hole, you can see that it doesn't line out perfectly, but we're pretty darn close. Let's see if we can get it out and then see if we have to cut any more. Before we get too far, let's just check and see if we get infinite resistance here. Multimeter set to read ohms resistance. And I'm not getting anything. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna have to pull this guy out. All right, just for fun, let's just see if we get any resistance. I've got the test leads on the sender, the output, and I've got them going here, and we're just measuring ohms, and not getting anything at all. So we're gonna go ahead and break this assembly open and see why. Okay, there are these four tabs here, 2, 3, and 4, and you just need to slightly bend those up. And then kind of this whole mechanism kind of comes apart. And we can see our resistive wire and our float assembly rotates on this little pin here. And this is the part that makes the contact right here. So I'm just going to fiddle around with it and see what exactly failed here and see if I can revive it. Okay, so I found that it's actually reading resistance on the resistive wire here, but it's not reading it up here, and I found a little break in the metal connection. See that? A little plastic bit that holds up the little wheel. This guy kind of fell off, and that's just getting all brittle. So I think this is going to work a lot better. Basically what I did is take a little bit of solid wire from a Romex cable, put a little crook in it, so a little bend, so that it sits in this tab here, and soldered that directly to the actual pickup here. And then took the wire and wrapped it around. Now, I didn't solder that. I've heard that you can't solder resistive wire. I'm almost worried that it'll damage it, but I mean, I don't think so. But anyway, it's a super solid connection if you get a really solid tight wrap on it. So I'm gonna go, and another thing that I did was take some really light sandpaper and go over this portion here. So now that we have it all buttoned up here, at empty, we're close to about 70. Looks like 75, well, 74.1 on mine, and all my cables are zeroed out. So let's go to about halfway. That's about 30 ohms. Now let's go to full. And about 4.5 ohms. Here's the part number. You can see it's original VW stuff. I like reusing the factory stuff just because if you buy aftermarket, you never know what you're gonna get. And this repair will probably last, who knows, probably quite some time. And if we ever do have to replace it with an aftermarket unit, the access hole that we have should make that really easy. We got it all cleaned up here. It's looking really nice, and I'm going to go ahead and install it now. Sender's in, our cables are on. Let's go take a look at the gauge real quick. Yes. Looks like we're a little over a quarter tank. Sweet. So I was gonna use this Subaru plate. It's pretty sweet, but maybe not for this use. So I just bent up a piece of sheet metal, pretty thick stuff, but it fits the grooves pretty well. I've bent it in the vise. I couldn't get the center bends. That was just pretty hard to do. But anyway, I'm just going to use this to sit over the hole here, and I'm gonna have to seal up these somehow, these valleys right here. Got the hole painted and the mounting plate painted, so I'm just gonna put a little bit of silicone sealant around. I did manage to lift these valleys up slightly. It's not perfect, but it's a pretty darn good fit, pretty close. So I'm gonna just seal around with some black RTV silicone sealant. It's all siliconed up and got it a little bit dirty, but that's what happens when you play with silicone. Anyway, I don't think it looks too bad in the scheme of things. Once we throw down some paint on this guy, I probably won't even be able to notice too much. Thanks again for joining on the fuel sender repair. I will keep this video updated as time goes on and if there's any troubles. So it was a pretty solid repair in my opinion. I have seen people take the resistance wire board apart and put new resistance wire on. That's usually when their wires are all broken. Mine, I lucked out. They were in great shape. I just needed to repair that one little portion of the tab that actually leads to the spade connector. So I lucked out. You may want to just buy an aftermarket one and drop it in and just repair the original one on your own time.
that is one option. But this is how I did it, and thanks for watching.